أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا ومولانا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. All praise belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May the peace and blessings of Allah be upon our noble Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, upon all of his companions, his family, and all of those who follow him to the day of Qiyamah. Ameen. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. As we all know, the month of Ramadan is approaching us. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made the dua, Allahumma barik lana fi Rajab wa Sha'ban wa balighna Ramadan. Allah bless us in the month of Rajab and Sha'ban. Give us your blessings, Ya Allah, and allow us to reach the month of Ramadan. Why did the Prophet ﷺ make this dua? What is the significance of the month of Ramadan? What can we hope to achieve? The Prophet ﷺ mentioned that if a person says that he has moved a mountain, then believe him. But if he says that he has left a bad habit, don't believe him. Because the Prophet ﷺ knew how difficult it is to leave these bad habits. How through our life we pick up a habit, and we see it very difficult to remove from our life, and very hard to keep a good habit. So these bad habits stay with us. But this month of Ramadan is an opportunity for us to change our entire life, to get rid of all of our bad habits and adopt good habits in our life. So what is the main purpose of Ramadan? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ السِّيَامِ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, that fasting has been prescribed upon you, like how it was prescribed upon those from before you. So we see that even nations before us, they were also fasting. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, so that you can achieve the quality of taqwa. So you can become a muttaqin, from the muttaqin. May Allah Ta'ala make us from the muttaqin. What, now Allah Ta'ala speaks about what is a muttaqin, what is taqwa, a lot in the Qur'an. We will just look at a few of the ayahs in the Qur'an to understand first what is taqwa. Allah Ta'ala mentions, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم, ألف لام ميم, ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه, هدى للمتقين. This is a book, and in it is no doubt, it is a guide for the muttaqin, the person who has taqwa. Now Allah Ta'ala in the next verses explains what is a muttaqin. Allah Ta'ala uses the word, الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ, that they are those who believe in the unseen. What is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala trying to tell us here? That in order for us to have taqwa, first and foremost we must believe. We must believe in the unseen. There's many aspects of the unseen, but what is the most important is to believe in Allah. So everything that we do, everything that we every step of the way, we must remember that we are doing it for the sake of Allah, that we believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We keep making sure that we reaffirm it to ourselves, La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And there's many other aspects of the unseen that we should believe in, the angels and the books of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, decree, the afterlife, many aspects. What does Allah ta'ala say after that? وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةِ, and they establish the prayers. So believing in Allah seems to be somewhat a simple and easy thing, but sometimes, as we know, it can become difficult. So Allah Ta'ala is helping us every step of the way. Allah Ta'ala is making it easy for us to understand, and through the explanation, that how do we achieve taqwa is to believe in Allah. How do we believe in Allah is to establish our prayers. We must establish our prayer with devotion, that every time we come to our prayer we know that we are standing in front of Allah. We're standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator of me, the creator of you, the creator of the heavens and the earth. And that we should come to a point that we are able for our heart to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is our goal, inshallah. And if we can't see Allah ta'ala with our heart, then know that Allah ta'ala is watching us. What does Allah ta'ala follow up after that? وَيُؤْمِنُوا بِالْغَيْبِ وَيُقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ, and from what we provide them, they spend. So sometimes in our salah, our heart is attached to the dunya. Sometimes it's very difficult for our heart to connect to Allah. So Allah Ta'ala is helping us again. Every step of the way, Allah Ta'ala is helping us. How do we achieve this good quality of salah, we must remove the love for the dunya from our heart. Allah Ta'ala is saying, spend. These people of taqwa, they spend their money in the path of Allah. So we need to remove that from our heart. The ulama kiram mentioned that believing is the most important thing. And then after that comes ibadah. So Allah Ta'ala is making a clear distinction between two types of ibadah. That which is of the body and that which is of the will. So we can see that they are salah and spending. So the ulama mentioned that salah has been mentioned in as the top of the rank of ibadah to do with the body. So we spend our energy and our time praying salah. We spend our energy and our time doing many ibadah. And as the month of Ramadan is coming up, we inshallah ta'ala can increase in that. So salah is up there. We have tarawih salah. We will stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We can read our Quran. There's many things that we can spend our time and our energy on. And the other category is spending our money. This is also another form of ibadah. That during our entire life, and especially during the month of Ramadan, if we want to achieve this quality of taqwa, if we want to make the most of the month that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made dua, that oh Allah allow me to reach the month of Ramadan. Why? Because it's such a blessed month. And if we want to take full opportunity, we need to make our extra salah, make that extra ibadah, and spend extra in the path of Allah. We need to give more sadaqah, inshaAllah. Allah Ta'ala continues, وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِمَا أُنْزِلَ إِلَيْكَ وَمَا أُنْزِلَ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ. That they are those who believe in what was descended on you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That we are talking about the Qur'an Kareem. Now, we need to make this Qur'an our life. We need to adopt the ways of the Qur'an. There's many aspects of the Qur'an that we can learn. We can learn from a child, we learn in the madrasa how to recite the Qur'an. What are the letters, the Arabic letters, how to recite it. And then further we learn the meanings of the Qur'an. So we can now start to understand the words, what is Allah Ta'ala telling me? We can start to implement the teachings of the Qur'an. And we need to sit by the scholars for them to give us the understanding. And then there's many, many sciences that come out from the Qur'an. Ajeeb, how many things can be taken out from just a couple of words of Allah, and then the scholars can elaborate and really tell us the deeper meaning. So we need to make this our life. We need to dedicate our life to adopting the ways of the Qur'an. And there's many ways of doing that, inshaAllah ta'ala. And Allah ta'ala allows us to stay in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I believe in that which was descended upon those from before you. So we are talking about the books of the past, the prior prophets, that we say we believe in them. We're not to become emotional and say that, oh, our Islam is the only Islam. But there has been prophets from before us, and we believe in them. Not to become emotional, but to become affectionate. Allah Ta'ala tells us that there have been prophets in the past, so we believe. It's not to become subjective, where we only see what is around us, but we become objective, inshaAllah Ta'ala. And Allah Ta'ala continues to explain what is the muttaqeen. وَيُؤْمِنُونَ بِمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ وَمَا أُنزِلَ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ وَبِالْآخِرَةِهُمْ يُقِينُونَ. And they have firm belief in the akhirah, in the afterlife. Now we've already spoken about the ghayb, and now Allah Ta'ala is mentioning al-akhirah. Isn't al-akhirah of the ghayb? So why does Allah Ta'ala do this? Which is a common occurrence in the Quran. Allah talks about believing in the unseen and believing in the akhirah. It's because we can believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala like other religions believe in Allah, but to have a firm belief that we are going to stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala changes everything. It changes that we have now a responsibility. Now what do we do with our time? How do we spend our time? Just to believe in Allah Ta'ala is not enough. We are going to be asked by Allah Ta'ala, what did we do? What was the quality of our salah? What was the quality of our giving, our spending? What was the quality of our belief? We will be standing in front of Allah Ta'ala, the creator of the heavens and the earth, and He will question us about these, inshaAllah. May Allah Ta'ala allow us to reach Him in a good state and not to fall short in any of our aspects, inshaAllah. Allah Ta'ala continues to finish off these groups of verses of the Qur'an. Allah Ta'ala honors the muttaqeen by saying, أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَىٰ هُدًى مِّن رَبِّهِمْ. فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. That indeed they are upon guidance from their Lord. It is only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that can guide us. Allah ta'ala is the one that hand selects us to guide us on the straight path. And Allah ta'ala is saying that definitely they are upon true guidance. They are successful. Allah ta'ala is telling us you will be successful if you are able to achieve this quality of taqwa. And what better month than the month coming up? And we need to start making preparations now, that we need to achieve this success that Allah Ta'ala is telling us we can achieve with this quality of taqwa. How did the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam prepare for the month of Ramadan? The Sahaba Ridwan said that the Prophet never fasted more consecutive than the month prior to Ramadan. So 15 days the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam would fast in preparation for Ramadan. So inshallah we can take some lesson from that and we can start our fast inshallah. We can start fasting our Mondays and our Thursdays. We can start first fasting different months inshallah. Now we should be starting to turn up the gears. When we want to go fast in the car, we first have a lower gear. You can't start in a high gear. Otherwise it starts off very, very slowly. You can't pick up speed. So we start in the low gear. We just start slowly, slowly. And when the time comes, we're ready inshallah. Very, very important that we utilize the time that we have. The time that we have is very valuable. Allah Ta'ala, when He wants to emphasize on something, He makes an oath. Like anybody, they make an oath upon something that is very important. So Allah Ta'ala uses an oath in the Quran in many, many occasions. And in one occasion He says, "Wal asr." We all know the surah. "Wal asr, innal insana fi khusr illa alladhina amanu wa aminu salihat." That by time. Allah Ta'ala is showing the importance of time. Verily, mankind is at loss, except for those who believe and perform pious actions. So we need to take opportunity of the time that Allah Ta'ala is giving us, and we need to aminu wa aminu salihah. Whenever Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala talks about those who believe, it follows up with wa aminu salihah. They perform good deeds. So as we say, that believing is one thing, but performing these deeds and hope for reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is another. Inshallah, may Allah ta'ala allow us to always be in some sort of ibadah, to have some sort of goal that we're trying to achieve, some sort of expansion on what we are doing. May Allah ta'ala give us the ability to carry on and then to take it always another step further inshallah. So this month of Ramadan is about islahu batin, about obtaining this quality of taqwa. We need to look within ourselves and inside ourselves. Islah al-batin is a concept of reconciliation of oneself. So this month gives us that opportunity. How does Ramadan give us that opportunity? Allah Ta'ala gives us this opportunity many, many times throughout the year. We have our salah. We have this time when we are taken away from the dunya. And we pray our salah, we stand in front of Allah 5 times a day. We are with company always, and it's very important the company that we choose. So during Ramadan, it's a balance between the two. We need to be in good company so that we can achieve the virtues of those who have come before us, those who are the friends of Allah Ta'ala, the pious and the scholars. We can derive the blessings from them. And then at the same time, we need to also make some sort of seclusion for ourselves. We need to take time away. And in the last 10 days of Ramadan, we have i'tikaf. Ramadan al-Buti, rahimallah, mentions in Fiqh al-Sirah about the concept of khulwa. Very briefly, he mentions about how the Prophet ﷺ would go into the cave of Hira before he was given prophethood, and he would contemplate and he would think about his fellow beings, his fellow colleagues, and he would think about his Allah, and he would worship his Allah. Sometimes days, weeks and months upon end, he would spend in seclusion. And Ramadan al-Buti gives many wisdoms behind this concept that we can take benefit from inshallah. That Ramadan al-Buti mentions that external worship, in order to achieve islahu batin, in order to achieve taqwa, as we have mentioned, external worship is not enough. We need to look within ourselves. We need to have that self-reformation. And secluding ourselves, khulwa, allows us to perfect our iman by removing all the distractions of the dunya, so we can focus upon ourselves. We can see within ourselves, what qualities do I have? What evil do I have within me? And then we can work upon that, inshallah. So this month is for us to seclude ourselves, to be in a good company, and then also to take that what we learn and to look in within inside ourselves. What evil qualities I have? What am I not doing for Allah? How much more can I do? This seclusion helps a person to remove from the dunya, as I mentioned, and then allow himself to start to feel these qualities. Now we spoke about removing the bad qualities quickly. Now what is the next step? We want to start feeling love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We want to feel this fear, that this taqwa, we can say taqwa is fear of Allah. So how do we feel fear? How do we feel this love of Allah? It's by removing all these evil qualities, and then these feelings start to come. Ramadan, Sheikh Ramadan Al-Budi mentions the contrast between somebody who feels what they are learning and somebody who does not. He gives the example of somebody who has come up with the algebra equation. He says you will never find anybody sacrificing his soul based upon an algebra equation. He's not going to sacrifice his life just to promote his algebra equation. This is only logic. There's no feeling in it. But when it comes to Islam, we come to a point where we start to feel. May Allah Ta'ala allow us to feel love, to feel fear, to feel shukr, to feel all these beautiful qualities. Because wallah, this is the goal. Once we have this taqwa, this is the feeling of taqwa. So important to understand that Ramadan, khulwa, seclusion is not the goal. Ramadan is not the goal. Allah, the Prophet ﷺ made a goal to reach Ramadan, but that's not the goal. The goal is not to reach Ramadan, but to achieve these qualities. So this is a means of achieving a higher goal, to achieve this quality of taqwa, to achieve these feelings, to achieve the removing all these evil qualities from us, inshallah. Allah Ta'ala, just to end off, Allah Ta'ala has put out for us, every single one of us, a particular place for us in Jannah. However, our actions, sometimes we don't fulfill that criteria of what Allah Ta'ala has, the high status Allah Ta'ala has given us. So therefore, Allah Ta'ala puts tests upon us. Allah Ta'ala tests us here and there. However, ulama kiram mentioned that if we are to avoid these calamities, first what we must do is perform good actions, perform more ibadah. So if we see ourselves being tested and we feel like we can't handle it, so turn to Allah. And we increase our ibadah, we increase that which is pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jazakumullah khairan wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.